morning, guys. Saturday morning. Looks like it's going to be a cracking day. So, going to head up to the Thieves Trail, which is just a little east of the Pentland Hills. And we're going to head from just next to Kirkmewton, head over towards Pennycook and see what the weather's like, see who's out and about and see what's going on. So, hope you enjoy the trip. So you can just see the hills over to my right as I'm driving and I leave my hometown, and the weather is phenomenal. I think it's the first time this year where I've left the house to walk and it's actually been sunny. I'm a bit later leaving today. It's 20 past 7 in the morning, normally on the hill by 7, but things are looking good. I'm excited. Just heading down through the dual carriageway in Livingston, and I can actually see the hills ahead of me. And typical Scotland, no matter how good the weather, there's white stuff lying on the hillsides. Always remember, folks, if you're out and about, keep yourself safe, take the right gear, because even though you're only going up a few hundred feet on this one, it can certainly make a difference here, because we're already somewhere like 600 to 700 feet above sea level. Weather's looking fantastic, hills are crystal clear, and look forward to this. Well, just driving along on an open bit of the countryside, managed to see the Oco Hills, the Pentland Hills, and even as far over as the Lomans up in Fife. It really is a crystal clear morning today. One of the advantages of living in central Scotland is you're never more than half an hour's drive from any hill range to get yourself out, and I heartily recommend it to anyone. Some geese take off first thing in the morning, ready for their journey. And this, folks, is where we are this morning. The Thieves Road, or the Coldstain Slap, depends where you come from. Looking out right across the Pentland Hills towards Edinburgh. Beautiful morning. And over in the distance, you can just make out Arthur's Seat. So even if you want to go walking, you're in the city, there's a hill right there for you. What more could you ask for? And this is basically where it's crossing the whole way up. I've actually hit what you would call a dry section, and even that's splunging, as we say here in Scotland. Great little example of what you're having to overcome. Just watch these rocks, guys, if you try and use them as stepping stones. They're as slippery as sin. Give you an example here. That's a dry bit. Here we go. Little soft spot. Always be careful of avalanches. You don't want swept off the hillside. Oh, I can see somebody's managed to get across this yesterday without sinking in. As you can hear, my feet are disappearing right into it. The sun softened it up. Right, this is what we're up against. Absolutely no dry spots. And these things covered in mud, grass and ice. Lovely. We're getting there. First beady sweat breaking out. You can see there, between the two hills, the path actually goes up over the middle part and heads down towards Pennycook. See what you can see, folks. Look over to the Lomans over in Fife. Just picking up, zoom in. You can just pick up the Forth Road Bridge, the new one. You can just see the old Forth Road Bridge to the right, and further over the Forth Rail Bridge. Zoom it back out, ground, you can just see the locals, the beginning, and through there, probably won't pick it up on the camera, but I'll try. You can just see over towards Callander and everywhere, and the beginning of the Highlands.
can see here, the path is boggy all the way. About to cut through that line in the heather towards the lower point of the valley. And this is pretty much what you're hitting all the way up. Trouble is, the paths make a natural runoff for the snow melt, so you end up ankle deep every few seconds. Only water, and it's not cold. Well, it's freezing, but the body's not cold.
Towards the borders, as you can see, there's still a lot of snow even down that as far south. Anyway, there's the target. Let's go. It's an interesting view for here. You can see the fence line I've just followed up, but the trail that I came up, the thief trail, actually more or less disappears into the horizon. You can see why back in the day the thieves used it. You could get up here, disappear through these hills, and be in the Pennycook area within a couple of hours with all your loot, mostly cattle. And then it became an access road for when the trains were opening up. We used to head to the West Lothian area down there, catch a train and head south back towards London. Now, you would think that's the cairn, and it is a cairn, but it's not the summit, because you can see the land rises up and the true summit's over there. I wonder how many people have come up, dropped a rock there and thought they were on the top. Dot dot. Anyway, onwards and upwards. Oh! And you can just see the peaks. Scald Law, I'm sure that is, we can see over there, just peeking up. We'll get a better photo, a better wee photograph or video for this. So you can see the little cairn. Basically turn left at that, head up another couple of hundred metres, and there's the true cairn. And you can't miss it, it's huge. Must be about 100 tonnes lying there. I wouldn't like to carry it up, guys. See you.
show you what we're looking at here. Looking towards Glasgow, swinging round, we're looking off Lanarkshire. Hills, the Forth Bridges, the Firthy Forth, Edinburgh, Arthur's Seat, Pentland Hills, looking towards Scaldlaw, etc. And then right down in the distance here, you're picking up the lowlands. You tell me. Who wouldn't travel 20 minutes from their house to come and see this? Amazing. Right, you'll see there's a handful of snow round about my stove there. Best laid plans and everything. Set the stove away, got my noodles on the go and taking some photographs, and I thought, I like black smoke coming off of that today. Yeah, that's because I'd left the ceiling ring on top of the stove when I lit it. So I need to invest in a new ceiling ring now. Schoolboy error, nearly set the hill on fire, but apart from that, emergency over, and everything's good. I'll get back to my views and my lunch now. Well, that's lunch nearly ready, so I'm going to have my dinner, my lunch I should say, and mini Snickers there as well, and sit and enjoy this view. I want video eating lunch, it's not a pretty sight. And I'll catch up with you guys in a bit. Well, I've just had, excuse the wind, I've just had my lunch. I'm sitting here watching light aircraft buzzing around the hills. I won't try and video it, it's not going to come in well. Probably hear them in the background, but thoroughly enjoyed my morning out. And I'm just going to take my bag and head back to the car now. And I'll catch up with you guys later on. Cairn on the summit where we had lunch, and as you can see, the weather's remained perfect the whole time we were here. I'm ready for a wee cup of tea now though, but I'm sure I'll be back to the car soon. Now see, that's what I like, just coming back down off the hills here, getting down towards the car park, bumped into another hiker heading up the way, and he stopped and blethered for 5 minutes about where we've been and where we're going and where we've been over the last few weeks. You know what? Too many people pass you in the hills, don't even look the road that you're on. This is the central London or the middle of Glasgow or any big cities. Stop and have a chat. You meet some characters, some good ones, some bad ones, but just be sociable people. It's great to meet the people that are out and about in the hills. section is like walking on carpet here. Every now and again you hit a wet spot, as you'll hear, but compared to up on the tops, much gooder, much gooder. Just stopped for a wee breather, a wee drink of water, having a look back. Can't believe how good the weather's been to me today. Simply stunning. Well, just coming back to the car park. I say I thoroughly enjoyed today. What a difference to get out and have a wee bit of nice weather. Ready though for a couple. We'll catch up with you guys. Well, back in the car, home ski. Cup of tea time. I'm just laughing, there was two young guys there. Just pulled up in the car park, getting ready to go. And they asked me what the conditions were like, and I said it's very, very wet underfoot, ankle deep at points. I will be alright. They arrived back after about 3 minutes, and they've moved on to find somewhere else to go hiking. So this one is a wet one, guys. Come prepared. But thoroughly enjoyed it, and I hope you did as well.